Don't think they don't know. They know it. The fact that they are allowing you to continue existing is because of what they are benefiting from you. Because what you are doing, they are not willing to do it. And they are using you to do it to get to what they want to get. Because if they hinder you from doing it, it will affect where they want to get to. The reason why the devil is coming now, the devil said, if you want God to stop blessing the people of God, call the people of God to go against the will of God, then God will stop blessing his people. That is what they are doing to you. You are connected to God, but they are making you to go against God, so that God will stop blessing you. He said the vision is for an appointed time. He said, though it tarries, wait for it. Certainly it will come to pass. Has God said anything concerning your destiny?
Yes.
And you think it is delaying?
No.
Wait for it. How many people are patient enough to wait for the promises of God? Are you walking in the light of God? Hallelujah. He said, but if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship. As we congregate this morning to praise God and to worship God, if we worship him in truth and in spirit, his glory will come down, his power will come down, his anointing comes down. When his power comes down, when his anointing comes down, tell me where that problem will stand before the anointing of God.
Tell me
where that sickness will stand. Tell me where that poverty will stand. We have heard people testify that they saw strange people that God sent from heaven to meet their needs. God is still in the business of doing that.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
He said we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ his Son cleanse us from all our sins.
Man, thank you, Lord.
Isaiah chapter 2, verse 2 and 3. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 2 and 3. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says, and it shall come to pass in the last day that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains, and shall be exalted above the hills, and all the nations shall flow into it. Amen. Take note of verse 3. He said, because the house of the Lord is on top of the mountain with light, on top of a tower, he said that many people shall say, who shall say? These people that are seeing this house on top of the mountain, they shall say, come, let us go up to where? To the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us what? His ways. He will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his path. For out of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. And don't forget, the Bible says the house of the Lord is no longer this building, because God does not dwell in this building again.
Oh,
where does he live now? He lives in you. You are the temple of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Where God dwells, where God talks, where God does whatever he does. And the Bible says, whoever toys with where God dwells, what happens to the person? He said, God will destroy.
Hallelujah.
Why are you allowing God to destroy your destiny? Bible says that you are the light of the world.
Amen.
He says he will dwell in you.
Yes,
yes.
Hallelujah.
So as a result of the light of God in his house on the mountaintop, which is like a tower, people of all races will begin to stream into this house, seeking to know and be taught of the law of God. Remember, you are a city set on high, and the word of God says that you are the temple of the living God. People will want to come and worship in Freedom House through you because of the testimony. They are the one that will ask you, brother, where do you worship? Show us the way.
Amen.
Not you carrying flyer. How many? Look, we just printed 5,000 copies of flyer money. That is what we do with the money you are querying me of. That is what we do with it. Can you talk to me about 4 cartons, 5,000 copies? Now, I was in where we were doing the evangelism yesterday. As we give some people, they will respectfully take it from you. And as you go for, how many of them did I pick yesterday as I was going, walking towards my car? I saw a lot of flyer. Those were the people you gave it to. You just look at it and say, they are like other people, they will drop it. So I was picking those flyers. Why do we waste resources? Is that what we need? Our life will be a leaflet. Our lives. Because the light protrudes out of our lives. Can I hear somebody say amen? Zechariah chapter 21 verse 22, the Bible says, and the inhabitants of one city shall go to another, saying, let us speedily, they say, let us go speedily to pray before the Lord and to seek the Lord of hosts. They are the ones, Zechariah chapter 8 verse 21 and 22, they are the ones that will be hungry for God. They are the ones, because of our life experiences, see. Because of our lives. I'm just opening a business somewhere. The business has not started. It has already become a counseling center. People are coming. They are saying, there's a new light in this environment.
Amen.
They have not even started though. It has become a light.
Amen.
So we are doing more of evangelism than the business we are setting up.
Amen.
How is your life reflecting on other people? Are you repelling people, or you are drawing people to God?
Right.
Your attitude, your utterances, your behavior, the way you react to people is dragging people away from the presence of God. He said the inhabitants of Lewisham and Catford, they will be looking for a specific church. Do you know how many people are migrating from one church to the other every day? They go to this church. What they are looking for, they won't find it there. They are looking for a place where they can find God. They are looking for a place where they can have true fellowship with God. They are looking for a place where they will have peace and harmony with God. You begin to wonder, after the grace, man, people who just sang, lifting up their hands and worshiping God, you will see them quarreling. And those people, you just finish service, so those people, they are peeping through the window, they are looking at you. Even the way you talk, you make noise. Don't you know that we are in another culture, we are in another environment? Learn other people's culture. Even as a preacher, the Oyibo people, they don't like shouting. So when we come to this environment, they say, why is he shouting? So me too, I'm learning how to talk gently. Praise the name of the Lord. He said they are the ones out of their own volition. They will be the ones seeking for God. Not we going to from one house to house, knocking at the other. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. I told you that these people, they are respectful. Unlike us. That you come to knock us. They say, why are you knocking at my door? They say, yes, excuse me. Thank you. God bless you. I'm busy. Gently. They don't want to talk to you.
And if they don't want to hear you, they don't pretend about it.
No.
But I can pretend. And I know that what you are telling me, I don't want to hear. But I will still open my ears and be listening. They don't listen. So the only way we can reach them is through our light that Jesus Christ is talking about this morning. This cannot happen except there is enough light to provide exemplary leadership. Exemplary leadership role model for others to see. Even within the church environment, people are looking for role model. Married people, how are you showing those who are not yet married that marriage is sweet? Because those who are not yet married, when they see the way you live your life as married people, they are dreading to go into marriage. Take a cue from every other thing. There are several of us who are experts in some areas. You see, some of these young people, they don't want to sit down and learn, but they want to make money. How are you mentoring them and telling them that life is not like that? Bible says that there is a way that seemeth right unto a man. He said, but the end of that road is a way of death. Brethren, it's not because I don't know how to preach prosperity. Do you know that men are in sizes? Prosperity is in faces. It is righteousness that exalts a man. Leviticus chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. Leviticus chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. Hallelujah. Leviticus chapter 6, verses 12 and 13. And the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it, it shall not be put out, and the priest shall burn on it every morning. The priest shall do what? Shall burn wood on it every morning. Now let's skip to verse 13. He said, the fire shall not be put out. The fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never do what?
Go out.
I want you to rise up this morning. I want to say, Father Lord, let your fire, let your light in my life never be put out. In the name of Jesus. Will you open your mouth this morning and talk to God? You are the last remnant that God is looking up to. You are the last person that God is counting on this morning. You are the very person that God is looking up to this morning. You are going to say, Father Lord, let your light upon my life not be put out. Will you open your mouth this morning and talk to God and say, Father, I'm a city according to your word that is set on high. Let not the light of God upon my life be put out. Let not the light of God upon my family be shut out. Let not the light of God, oh God, in my finances be put out. Let not the light of God in my career be put out. Open your mouth and talk to God this morning and say, Father Lord, do not let me repel people away from your kingdom. I'm a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. Father Lord, a peculiar person that you have called to show forth your glory in this dark world. Brethren, you are not praying. Open your mouth and talk to God this morning. Open your mouth and reach out to God this morning. The Spirit of God is here this morning. You are a change agent this morning to bring about righteousness on the planet Earth. I want you to open your mouth and talk to God and say, Father, Lord, help me. Every darkness in my life, let it disappear this morning.